And we'll get started in just a second here, as soon as we get a few people signed on, and we'll get going talking about the chances of snow over this holiday weekend coming up. So hang on, we'll get started in about 15 seconds there. And about 10 more seconds, and we'll get going on this. There still is a chance for some snow, no big snowstorms for the holiday weekend, but there is a chance for some snow coming up, which we will get to in just a second. Hang on, taking care of sharing this to another site real quick here, and then we'll get going. The internet is running a little slow. Hang on. I tell you, while I'm waiting for that, I'll go ahead and put this map up here for you. This was released this morning. This is, hello everybody, John Belsky here. And the drought monitor is released once a week. And the yellow area across southeast, south central, and west Kentucky is considered abnormally dry. Now, this will not last long because we've got a pretty good rain system coming in. And the heaviest amounts will be falling over southern Kentucky. So, hold on. Okay, I'm ready to roll on this now. So, anyway, let me show you the latest. Let's talk about this rain system first, okay? This is the NAM computer model, and it's backed off. Last night, it was forecasting 2 to 2.5 inches for Louisville. That would be this orange area. That has shifted south. The red that you see in there is 3 inches, and then the dark red is 4 inches down across far southwest Kentucky there. So Louisville is generally in the inch to an inch and a half range. I mean, it's still a pretty decent rainfall, but basically cut in half from what it was last night. GFS, about the same thing there. See the yellow, again, the yellow is 1 3/4 or higher, and that's south of Louisville. In fact, the GFS has, let's see, about an inch and a quarter for Louisville. And let's do the Euro model, and that has about an inch and a half for Louisville. So again, pretty decent soaking, but the heavier rains where they need it even more further down south, southern Kentucky, down into Tennessee. All right, let's talk about these snow chances for Christmas, all right? And the last few days we've been saying the big snowstorm was off the table because it was coming in as a rain system for Friday here. It just wasn't cold enough. The only question was, this weak system coming in on Christmas Eve will be enough to give us a little bit of snow. Here is the latest. This is the NAM model. Okay, Chris wants to know what time the rain starts tomorrow. It's a shower chance during the day. The steadiest, heaviest rains, though, will be tomorrow night and through Saturday, especially during the morning hours there on that. Okay, so here we go into tomorrow night. And see here, you can see a few sprinkles breaking out here tomorrow night. And then the steady rains in Arkansas this is Friday morning. So the steady rain's still out of here. In fact, most of Friday should be dry and may even hit 60 degrees here before that rain arrives. This is, let's see, here we are. This is about 2 o'clock in the afternoon. So the rain arrives in the afternoon. Look at that, almost the entire state of Kentucky. It could be raining at one point, but there's no snow with this. Here comes the low, it's in Arkansas. It's like a conveyor belt. Look at that long stream of moisture coming in there. Starting to see a little bit of snow popping up out in Missouri. This is Friday night. Oh, getting a little bit on that northwest edge, but it's much further. Yesterday, the NAM had heavy snow for southern Indiana. You know, we weren't really buying into it. It looked kind of weird to see that on there. Now it's really backed off and moved that further north again. And this is mid-morning Saturday, and then boom, it's out of here Saturday afternoon, okay? Yeah, Jill, I agree with you. If that was cold air, if it was cold air with an inch and a half of rain would mean 15 inches of snow. Not going to happen. Okay, so let's go into Christmas Eve and see if the NAM has anything. There's something way out in western Nebraska. And you see it just weakens it as it comes through here. So the NAM has nothing. Nothing here in the way of snow for Sunday or Sunday night. Now let's switch over to the GFS, which has had nothing. It had nothing for the Sunday deal. It had just rain for the Friday, Saturday. Now it has popped up with some snow. This is Saturday night. It's got a, you know, area of snow. It's light, but it's snow. You're welcome, Chris. And yeah, we'd like to see a bit of snow in here. Okay, now let's go into Sunday morning. I mean, this is not impressive, but it's something that it did not have before. And there you go. It has Louisville on the southern edge of the snow. And this is at Sunday early afternoon, midday Sunday, let's call it, okay? So it's coming in fairly fast. not, you know, nothing all that heavy. But again, in fact, let me go back. Let me show you 24 hours ago what the GFS had. That's what it had. Nothing. And then let's go 12 hours ago, the GFS had nothing. And then 6 hours ago, it had, okay, it started with a little bit of snow. Now the current run, much larger area-wise, but not too intense, few tenths of an inch, basically. That's it. So we'll see it in the future, you know, over the next couple of runs here, if it continues to increase that. Now, the European model has had this area of light snow over the last couple of days. In fact, it did have, last night, it had Louisville getting up to a half inch. So here's the latest one. Where you see the blue, this is a six-hour snow total, and where you see the blue, that's over an inch. So the dark gray is a half inch, and that's like a tenth of an inch in the light gray. Okay, so this is Saturday night. Now we'll go into mid-morning Sunday, and amounts for that six-hour period, early Sunday, are all less than a half inch. Now we go into Sunday afternoon, picks up in intensity, but it's well north of Indianapolis. It looks like Lafayette over toward just south of Fort Wayne, calling for over an inch, and that would be during the afternoon hours on Sunday. And then we go into Sunday evening, and you know it comes close with a tenth of an inch here. So as of now, the European model basically has a chance for some flurries or a little bit of light snow here for Christmas Eve, and the GFS has added that flurries or light snow in the forecast for Christmas Eve, and the NAM still doesn't have anything on snow there. So that's the latest how it stands right now as far as your snow chances for Christmas. Now let me go back to this here, and let's just see what the GFS has for next week after Christmas. This is back to Christmas Eve evening now, and you see it really starts to intensify a little more of a darker in there. In fact, watch what happens to this overnight. You know, dropping some snow amounts into Pennsylvania, and by Christmas morning, maybe actually be producing some heavier snows in New England. Now, if this would go back and intensify faster, we could see a spurt of snow. Now, again, the rain thing, Jamie, that you're talking about is for Friday into early Saturday. We're not going to have any snow with that, okay? See, this is 540 line. That's your rain snow line. This is Sunday afternoon. So it's plenty cold enough for snow. It's just a matter of will it pass to the north of us, or can we get that burst of light snow to move through here? Okay, so let's go into next week just for fun here to see if the GFS is saying about the next system. And, okay, it's showing a snow system. This is Wednesday night of next week. Really shears it out. Okay, and then, here's late in the weekend. This is late in the week. This is now Thursday night. Kind of an overrunning situation, okay? Cold at the surface, and the warm air rides and the moisture rides aloft, so you get freezing rain over southern Kentucky and snow here. And that's, again, that's a long way off. Nothing may come of this. This tries to blow it into a pretty good snowstorm. So we'll see how that develops, and there it shifts off to the east of us then for the New Year's weekend there. So, you know, there's signs that we could get something next week. And we've seen that before, you know, a week out where it either turns out to nothing or more often than not, it turns into rain. So we'll have more updates on that. But again, for Christmas, unless that GFS and unless the European shifts south a bit and unless the GFS can shift south a little bit and intensify a little more, at the most right now, just a dusting or a light coating if we get some light snow in the area. And it's still in the chance category, certainly nothing for sure. All right, any last questions from anybody? Otherwise, I'll check your comment section later on and put my answers there. But that is the latest how it stands for now as far as any snow for the upcoming weekend. That's it? All right, that's all I see. So I'm going to sign it off for now. If there's any major changes with the new updates coming in this afternoon, I'll do another quick video this evening. Otherwise, we'll do another update for you tomorrow on the Christmas weekend forecast. Have a great day. Thanks for watching.